Hello. Today I'm going to show you how to install Downshift on Ubuntu 18.10. You can use this method to install it on any Linux-based, the Debian-based operating system. And in the link, in the description of this video, you will find the way how to install it with a script on any Linux distro. It's going to be a fantastic tool. They call it a backup tool. I don't really think it's a, it is a backup tool, but it's not a backup tool of your data. It's like a system restore port. So if your computer break, won't help you at all. But if your computer, if you mess something up on your computer or something like that, or something odd happened and you have to restore your computer to what it was before, this is fantastic. So it's a restore point by default it doesn't back up your data at all because it will take too much space. But if you want to do it, it's easy to do it as well. So it's a fantastic little app which does a lot. It got a lot better in the last year since Linux Mint added by default to the system. And this is a cool thing for me about Linux. It improved everywhere. So everywhere it's better. It's very smooth. I'm running this on my system. So yes, it's a fantastic tool for a restore point snapshots of your system. So as you can see, the installation is done. I'm just gonna close up everything. And now if you go to Downshift, is this red icon here? Type in your password. There we go. And you can choose between rsync or butterfs. I always choose rsync, but it's up to you. And depending on the size of your computer, this might take longer or shorter than for me, as I'm doing all my videos, tutorial videos in virtual machines. This is also in a virtual machine, but it will work anywhere. Like I said, I'm using this on my host machine. I got it set up as well. So as you can see, we're nearly done with this piece. And now it will see your hard drive, it's next. And now you can choose if you want to have a monthly, weekly, or you can choose 2 or 3 also if you want to. I like a weekly one because I don't add and restore, add and delete too many apps. So a week, if I lose my things for a week, it is fun. I can restore it and I'll be very happy. And here, as you can see by default, they do not include your home folders, but you can untick it, or include all, or include hidden. So it's pretty neat. So hidden might be a nice way to go. I will even do it for my system, because all the hidden config packages and things like that I want. So that's pretty neat that I can have that option also. So now I'm just gonna click finish. And now you can close this up. It will run the restore points automatically. You don't have to do anything anymore. You can test it out by creating one and then just close it, forget about it, and when you need it, it's there. Isn't that how things would work? So as you can see, we are creating one, but now I'm gonna not wait for this to be finished before I'm finishing this video. But just as you can see how it basically does it. And it doesn't take too much space, and they store the files by default. You can of course change the location, but by default I can make a symbolic link to the place and store it on external share or something. But by default it's been shared here in your root folder on the Downshift. So as you can see, the package is currently being created here. So that's quite cool. Yeah, so it all happens in the background. You don't have to worry about it. You don't have to think about it. And It works great. So yeah, thank you for watching. See you later. Goodbye.